This is Robert Picardo, and you're watching The Planetary Post.
This month's Planetary Post is about a really important topic, planetary defense. That's watching out for asteroid impact. But first, back in 1975, Planetary Society co-founder Carl Sagan appeared on The Tonight Show and showed Johnny Carson a model of one of his dream technologies, a solar sail.
Well, there's a just tremendously exciting prospect called solar sailing.
Solar sailing.
And which travels on the radiation and particles that come out of the sun, the wind from the sun. See, it's a whole new kind of idea.
The Planetary Society has been working hard to make our co-founder's dream come true. CEO Bill Nye recently repeated history by sharing our new light sail model with Late Show host Stephen Colbert and a new television audience. Let's watch.
Well, you're also the CEO of the Planetary Society, working on something called, which was founded by Carl Sagan.
Carl Sagan talked about solar sailing back during the disco era. The pressure of sunlight pushes it through space. We launched it and it worked, and we want to launch another one, Light Sail 2. Came up with that ourselves.
You can find a link to the whole clip in the Planetary Post email. Next, this is Planetary Defense Month on the Planetary Post because earlier this month there was the giant Planetary Defense Conference in Japan. So I have invited my friend from Jet Propulsion Laboratory, Dr. Amy Mainzer, to join us today. Thanks, Amy. Have a seat. Well, my first question is asteroid impact. It's not going to happen before the end of this interview.
No, we're good.
Good. Okay, yeah. Good, because I have finally got Hamilton tickets. And anyway, you are kind of the point person at JPL for asteroids that could potentially threaten us.
Well, I'm one of many people at JPL, which is a good thing. We've got a lot of people who are looking out for us. I'm working on the NEOWISE mission.
NEOWISE.
Near Earth Object Wide Field Infrared Survey Explorer mission. We love our acronyms at NASA.
I'm so glad I didn't have to say that myself.
And NEOWISE is a space telescope. It's orbiting the Earth, and it's looking outward, looking for asteroids and comets that get close.
People who ask, what can I do to protect myself from asteroid impact? I'm guessing that's not it.
Yeah, that's probably not going to work.
Okay.
No, sorry.
Now, on Star Trek, we would have just used a tractor beam and dragged it out of, harm's way. Do you have one of those to drag it out of the way?
I wish I did. It would make it a whole lot easier to get through traffic on my way to work.
What do you have? Do you have like a directed energy beam?
The simplest thing we have available to us is what we would call a kinetic impactor. And that's basically a fancy way of saying you run into it with something heavy.
It's like shooting a big cannonball from Earth.
Exactly.
To knock it off course.
Right. About 90% of the really big near-Earth asteroids have been discovered to date. And that includes objects that are big enough to cause very big global problems. That's the good news. Most of those have been found and are tracked. For the smaller objects, which are still capable of causing problems at a regional scale, we still have more work to do.
If you at home are wondering, what can I do to help protect us from asteroid impact, the Planetary Society has something called the Shoemaker NEO Grants.
And we actually collaborate with some of the Shoemaker Grant winners. They supply follow-up observations of many of our candidate discoveries.
So you are using information from the grant winners at Jet Propulsion Laboratory.
Yes, we do. Planetary defense is a team sport, and so it really revolves around having contributions from a lot of different people all over the world.
Amy, it's so interesting to talk to you. In all fairness, I thought maybe you have some questions for me about being a celebrity on one of the Star Trek series or anything you'd like to ask me?
No.
Like about how cool it is to have an action figure?
No, that's okay.
Sure.
The truth is, yes, I want to hear all about it. Tell me all about Star Trek. I really want to know.
We'll do that. We'll do that next time.
Okay.
So let's talk a little bit about the Planetary Defense Conference that just concluded in Japan.
This is a conference that brings together all kinds of people from the planetary defense communities.
And you and I have a mutual friend who was at the conference, Dr. Bruce Betts, the Planetary Society's Director of Science and Technology, and also the host of... love that reverb. Why don't I get reverb on my voice?
You don't have reverb? Have reverb?
Bruce took some clips at the conference, and we get to enjoy them right now. Have a look.
Hey, this is Dr. Bruce Betts. I'm at the Planetary Defense Conference in Tokyo.
where experts have come together to talk about how to save the Earth from asteroids.
The Planetary Society is proud to be a primary sponsor of the Planetary Defense Conference because it brings together experts from around the world in all aspects of the asteroid threat problem. At the conference, I've announced our new call for proposals for our Shoemaker NEO Grant Program, which mostly funds very advanced amateur astronomers to upgrade their observatory facilities to make real contributions to stopping the asteroid threat.
Well, I've got to head back into the conference where later I'll be presenting a talk about the Planetary Society 5-step plan to prevent asteroid impact. Sayonara.
Hey, Bruce. Thanks for helping to save our planet. I'd also like to thank my guest and friend, Dr. Amy Mainzer.
Oh, thank you.
And present you with this souvenir asteroid.
Wow, thanks. Cheapest sample return ever. Thanks, Bob.
And if you'd like to help protect our planet, please consider a donation to the Shoemaker NEO Grant Program by going to planetary.org/neo. See you next time.